Good morning to everyone who has taken your time out to join us this morning on this very exciting webinar today. My name is Dan Greer with Insurance Advisors Direct, and we really appreciate all of our agents who have taken time out of their busy selling season time to join us today for a brand new product rollout from Philadelphia American. The Health Savers Plus Gold Edition. And just a little bit of background here, you know, Insurance Advisors Direct is a almost 10-year-old company now, and we started out focused on the senior market. And as time went along here and with the advent of the Affordable Care Act and health insurance premiums skyrocketing for the under 65 market, we realized that we needed to have an alternative because as we work the Medicare market, you don't run across married couples that age in at the same time very often. And so a lot of the times, younger spouse gets stuck without an employer benefit any longer, and they have to go into the marketplace. Well, that's the worst time of their life to have to spend $800, $900, $1,000, or $1,100, $1,200 a month for health insurance. That's really terrible with high deductibles and everything. So fortunately, approximately 3 years ago now, we connected with Philadelphia American, who has a full suite of under 65 products, to help folks in that situation. And their plans have constantly become better and better, and this is their latest and greatest product. And I have to say, as someone who researches these products, I mean, there's probably literally hundreds of these types of hospital indemnity products out there, but I really believe that this has to be, if not the richest benefit plan for hospital indemnity fixed benefit products, it's got to be in the top three or so. And joining us this morning, we're very happy to have Mr. Jeff Urbano. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, Jeff. Jeff is joining us in place of Dave Collette, who is the Vice President of Sales and Marketing for Philadelphia American. And Dave, unfortunately, had a family emergency this morning, and Jeff was able to step up to the plate and join us this morning. So, by the way, before I turn it over to Jeff for a moment, we are recording this webinar, and we will send you all a link when we have it ready, probably early next week. So with that, Jeff, I'm glad that you are able to step up for Dave today and help us out in presenting the Health Saver Plus Gold Edition. We have several agents on here who are familiar with the Health Choice Select and the Health Savers Plus 3. And then there's also several new agents on here, too. So thank you very much, Jeff, and go ahead, and we'll just have a nice discussion this morning and try to keep it to about an hour, okay?
All right, sounds good. Hey, guys, my name is Jeffrey Urbano. Just a little background about me. I've been with the company for 16 years. My background is I've always been in marketing services, but a little bit of senior market, and as of last year, I joined the under 65 group, and there's a reason for that, because this Health Saver Plus Gold that we just came out, like Dan said, it's nothing compared. I mean, it's compared to the other companies, our benefits are so much richer, okay? But that being said, thanks for having me today. I know you guys are busy. Like Dan said, it's the busy season. Thank you for having me. Without further ado, I'll continue with the presentation, okay? All right, so again, the product that we're going to talk about today is the Health Saver Plus Gold. This came out as of, I believe, August the 15th of this year. And It's interesting that Dan mentioned that, you know, the agency has been open for 10 years. This product, the Health Saver Plus, also came out in 2009. I believe this is the fourth volume that we've revised. So every time we upgrade, we come out with a new product. It started with Health Saver Plus 1, and now, like I said, so it's health, and then it went to Health Saver Plus 2, 3, and now we're at the Health Saver Plus Gold. And we just continue to keep getting it better, okay? And that being said, I'll show you guys. Also, August the 15th, we came out with two other products, the Specified Disease and the Accident Expense. Okay, this is, I think the next slide, there you go. We have the gold products approved in all the green states, including Pennsylvania and Tennessee. They were just recently approved. I believe Virginia as well was approved this past week. So as you can see, if you guys are licensed in multiple states, these are the states that we have the Health Saver Plus Gold. Again, Pennsylvania and Tennessee, we just got approved. It's on the website. It's on our portal. They work a little bit differently, but, you know, they're ready out there, okay? And then along with the three products that we have, this is the list of the products we have available currently with all the states. I know it's a little bit hard to see, but you also find this on our portal.
Yeah, Jeff, okay. Just so everyone knows, this may be an introduction for some of you, and some of you may be familiar with the Agent Dashboard and the New Era Life portal. Please, I'm here for any help you may need as we go forward. If you need the contracting or I can help you get your feet underneath of you, quoting and enrolling folks on this. It's very easy to use online quoting and enrollment. So sorry to interject there, Jeff. Jeffrey.
Oh, no.
Go ahead.
Thank you. Thank you so much. All right. So, okay. So this is my boss's PowerPoint. So as he liked to start, he likes to ask these three questions. Would you shop at a store that didn't have any prices, okay? I'll give you guys a second to think about that. My personal answer is no. Who wants to shop at a store with no prices? Second question that he asked, if you were given a debit card with, say, $100 on the card, and you went to the same store without prices, would that make you feel fine, okay? Again, a debit card with $100, but no prices. Yeah, I guess that'll make me feel a little bit better. Not so much. Would you buy a car based on MSRP on the window or negotiate the price to a reasonable, affordable amount? That I can honestly say, I've never bought a car in my life. That sticker price, you can always negotiate with that, okay? Just in case you guys don't know. The reason he brings this up is because it's just like car, everything you can negotiate, okay? And I say that because with our product, we have what we call the multi-plan network, which is PPO. It's one of the largest. If you take advantage of that, basically you get a little bit of discount. And that being said, it's actually going to get repriced. So you can always negotiate, and we have people in our home office that actually do that as well. All right, just a little comparison about our product versus major medical. Okay, major medical plan pays based on claim, pays after deductibles, co-pays, and has out-of-pocket, okay? All right, we don't have co-pays, we don't have out-of-pocket. The negatives about major medical: usually requires a patient to stay in network or face a huge penalty, okay? Have little first dollar benefits due to high deductible, face 20% or more rate increases annually, and then may have new pre-existing clause or never cover pre-existing condition. So just to give you, again, comparison with ours, we don't penalize your clients for going out of network. In fact, Our product enables them to go any doctor, any hospital. Okay. We do have deductibles on our product. The deductible only applies, and again, I'm getting ahead. I'll explain more later on the slide, but yeah, the deductibles only apply when they stay at a hospital for 24 hours or more with ours. Our rate increases are typically low. I don't recall seeing double digits, the 16 years I've been here. We do have pre-existing. It only lasts for 12 months, so after 12 months, it's covered. All right, so we don't pay claims, we pay benefits. Again, what that means is it's a fixed indemnity policy. All the benefits are fixed. Everything you're going to see on the brochure is what we're going to pay. We give people access to dollars. What that means is if your client shops smart, and we have people actually, again, in the home office that's going to guide them. We have carers. If they shop smart, they could actually, there's a possibility that they could put money on their pockets. And again, we pay based on the plan, not the claim. All right, so just a little overview on our product. It's got a $5 million lifetime maximum policy, three annual maximum benefit amounts to select from. That would be the $250,000, $500,000, or $1 million. Three benefit options to pick from. That would be 1, 2, or 3 unit. Again, use any doctor or hospital you choose without penalty. And for additional savings, we have the PHCS network is available at no additional cost. We also have Teladoc. Telemedicine provides a convenient alternative to urgent care or ER visits at no cost. And then Script Save Card is provided at no cost as well, where they can get discounts with prescription. And as I mentioned earlier, we have the Caris Group provides concierge service to help policyholder navigate the complexity of the healthcare marketplace. And again, along with our gold product, you can also add, we have the accident, life, critical illness, dental plan are available to enhance your protection. All right, so this is our brochure right now. The main thing on this slide is, again, what we're offering is a fixed indemnity benefit, okay? As it says right there, these benefits are paid in specific amounts and do not provide expense reimbursement for charges based on your health care provider's bill. Okay, so this is, let me see, this is the inpatient part, okay? At the top, again, as if you can see it, they have to choose, your client has to choose between the three maximum benefits, 250, 500, or a million. Again, 1, 2, or 3 units, and then they choose the deductible. All those choices they make, it's going to reflect on their premium. So, for example, if you do somebody with 250,000, one unit, with $10,000 deductible, that's going to be the most affordable plan, whereas if you put somebody on 1 million, 3 unit, and $100 deductible, that would be our richest plan, okay? All right, so moving on the inpatient side, again, they choose the deductible, as you can see, from $100 to $10,000. Okay, what separates us from other companies, actually, is we have what we call the hospital admission benefit for the first inpatient day. So say, for example, they choose the $10,000 deductible, like I said. So if they're admitted in the hospital, again, this applies for 24 hours or more, as you can see on the check marks right below that. If they're admitted in the hospital, they actually get $3,000 back on their first day. So that actually knocks their deductible down to $7,000, okay? And then right below
may I interject here for a second?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
No, go ahead, just please.
So is the deductible, it applies to first day inpatient confinement, that's just once per calendar year, is that correct?
That is correct, yes, sir.
Okay, I just wanted to clarify that for everyone listening. The deductible only applies to the first day inpatient confinement, once per calendar year, So if they are admitted again later in the year, there is no deductible. And the all the other benefits that you're going to see, like daily outpatient benefits, you'll have access to those immediately. No deductible on that part.
That is correct. Okay. All right. Thank you for that, Dan. So, again, going back, hospital confinement. This is what we pay on the room charge, okay? As you can see, the middle plan, we pay for sickness. We pay $3,000 per day on the sickness and then $45 for the injury. Again, I'm talking about the middle plan. I talk about the middle plan because that's what my boss likes to preach. If you can do it, he likes to promote the 250,000 calendar year max, the two unit, and then either the $5,000 or $7,500 deductible. And again, the reason for that, I'm going to explain. And of course, if they have the budget, you know, the three unit plan would be the richest plan out of all. Okay. Again, for the sickness, for the room, we pay $3,000 per day, and then $45 for injuries. And then right below that is confinement in a hospital's intensive care unit. We pay $4,500 per day for that, and then $5,000 per injury. Yesterday, someone asked me, if somebody's in ICU, would we pay both benefits? The answer is no. We only pay one or the other. So if they're in ICU, we pay, like, for example, for sickness, we pay $4,500 per day. And as you can see in there, we pay up to 20 days per calendar year. And what that means is basically if they're there for more than, let's just say they're there for 21 days, okay? That 21st day, it doesn't mean they're not going to get paid anymore for their room. So that 21st day, we're actually just going to pay the $3,000. So if you have somebody that's in ICU for more than 20 days, the hospital confinement benefit is what kicks in after that. All right, so also confinement in a hospital for mental illness, alcohol, or substance abuse. Again, for the middle plan, we pay $400 per day. Confinement in a rehab facility or skilled nursing facility, we pay $1,500 per day for that. All right, outpatient hospital or ambulatory surgical services, we pay $3,500 per day on that one, okay? Example for that would be like a colonoscopy. So these are benefits for surgery performed under general anesthesia. And then right below that, benefits not requiring anesthesia, it's $1,500 per day. Okay, we also pay outpatient radiation therapy, chemotherapy, and let me see, I can't read it very clearly.
There's immunotherapy.
Thank you.
Immunotherapy, Jeffrey. and real quick, also, you mentioned colonoscopy. The only time the colonoscopy is classified as outpatient surgery under anesthesia would be if polyps are removed. We'll get to that later when we talk about preventative care.
All right, moving on. So again, think of the maximum benefit that they get. Think of it like a bucket. So basically every January 1st, which is coming up, we fill up that bucket based on the choice that they make. So if you sign up somebody, for example, for November 1st, for $250,000, they get that $250,000. Even if they use it for November, December, come January 1st, we fill up that bucket one more time for a whole $250,000.
Yeah, I think the one page there, this one, is all showing right. The average hospital stay amounts, a
that
nationwide figure, and then you have nonprofit hospitals and for-profit hospitals. So
yes.
In Michigan, which is not listed, the average is right around $2,100 or $2,200 at a for-profit hospital. That's for the room and board part, about $2,100 or $2,200 per day.
Yes, sir. So I'm in Texas, actually. So As you can see, for Texas, it's for nonprofit hospital. It's about $2,600 per day. As you recall what I said, the middle plan that we have, it pays $3,000 per day, okay? So that should be plenty enough of money. If you have any clients in California, we would suggest probably doing the three units. As you can see, in California, the room and board's a little bit more. It's $3,800 per day. That's the average. So probably put them on the three-unit plan if you can, or if it's within their budget.
Now, Jeffrey, is this product available in California now?
Interesting that you asked that. So we did file back in the summer. It's still not approved, unfortunately. I believe we do have the Health Choice Select over there, right? I'll double check on that. We do have a product there, but just not the Health Saver Plus Gold yet, unfortunately.
Okay, yeah, and we can always refer back to the product availability chart that is available in the dashboard that's constantly updated.
Correct. Yeah, I just looked at my notes. We do have it in California for the Health Choice Select, not the Gold yet. We're trying.
Yeah.
Okay, so professional services. Okay, so inpatient physicians care indemnity benefit. Again, for the middle plan, we pay $100 per day. All right, surgery indemnity benefit for covered services when performed in a hospital or in an ambulatory surgical center. We pay two times the RBRVS, okay? For those of you, and I know I had to Google this myself, so RBRVS is basically the Medicare fee schedule. It's very commonly used on the Medicare supplement. So we use that schedule. And again, for surgeries, covered services performed in a hospital, we pay two times that Medicare fee schedule. Okay? Inpatient pathology, radiology, indemnity benefit. Again, we pay two times the Medicare schedule, Medicare fee schedule for the middle plan. If they have an assistant surgeon, we pay 20% of surgical benefit payable. And then anesthesia, 25% is what we pay per day. Okay?
Okay, Jeffrey, let me stop you right here for a moment. Now,
okay.
So let's say if I'm on this plan and I go in and I have an appendectomy, I'm going to get the surgery benefit plus the assistant surgeon benefit, if there is one, assistant
Correct.
Surgeon. And the anesthesia. This is all gets combined together, correct?
All combined, correct, yes, sir. Yeah, I wish I had the exact amount on that. I'll share this with you. I was helping somebody yesterday for shoulder, I believe it was shoulder replacement. I mentioned that because it was an outpatient surgery. Again, we paid $3,500 for outpatient surgery. I don't know if I can go back to the slide. So $3,500 for that, and then we pay for the surgery two times the Medicare fee schedule. I believe it was $900 for that procedure. So we paid, in addition to the $3,500, we pay $1,800 because it was two times the Medicare fee schedule. There was no assistant surgeon, but we also paid, I believe, $600 for anesthesia. So here it is. Thank you. So outpatient hospital or ambulatory surgical services, for the middle plan, it's $3,500 for surgery performed under general anesthesia. So just to give you guys an idea, that's what we pay. If they are admitted for over 24 hours, the same thing. We pay for the room, the hospital confinement. We pay for the surgeon. Again, if they have an assistant, we pay 20% of that. And then anesthesia, 25%.
So the benefits all stack up. Sometimes what I do is I use an appendectomy as an example, and I just use, let's say hypothetically that the Medicare fee schedule says $10,000 for an appendectomy.
Okay.
Then we just do the math. So you have $20,000 for the appendectomy. You get $4,000 for the assistant surgeon and $5,000 for the anesthesia. So technically, you're getting $29,000 for the surgery, plus however many days the doctor comes in your room to check on you and say, you know, boy, aren't those Dallas Cowboys doing great this year? Because they charge for that, right, Jeffrey?
They do.
Okay. So you would get the $29,000, let's say you're in the hospital 3 days, $29,300 plus whatever your hospital confinement benefit is on top of that, and then they would take the deductible away from the total. Is that how that works, Jeffrey?
That's correct. That is exactly. And don't forget about that hospital admission benefit. So, like, again, if you choose the $10,000 deductible, they get that $3,000 if it's their first time. So they get that first benefit per calendar year, one per calendar year. So even though they choose the $10,000 deductible, it actually knocks it down to $7,000. But to go back to your question, yes, that's basically how it works. We apply that deductible to the total amount and then go from there and see what the total is. Okay? All right, so my favorite part is the outpatient side. In case you guys don't know, 70% of our claims are mostly outpatient. And then it's a little bit hard to see at the top, but for the outpatient side, they get the aggregate calendar year max. So for the first plan, the unit plan, I mean the value plan, it's $4,000, middle plan $6,000, and then the preferred plan it's $8,000. So they get, that's their maximum calendar year for the outpatient. That's plenty of money, guys. Just to give you an idea. Right below that is the physician indemnity benefit. That's your doctor's visit. As you can see, the middle plan we pay $120. Per day, okay? Yesterday I was actually helping some lady. She's in Dallas. So she was going to see her doctor. Before she went to go see her doctor, she actually asked for a price. And, you know, they gave her the $300 amount. I couldn't believe it, but that's a true story. So, Jeff, this doctor wants to charge me $300 per doctor visit. And I told her, ma'am, you only have, she had the three-unit plan. $160 to $160. I told her that's all we're going to pay. Unfortunately, it's a fixed benefit. So for her case, she would have been responsible for the additional $140. I found her another doctor just literally like 5 miles down the road from her, that charged $100 per doctor visit. Again, she had the 3-unit plan. We pay a fixed benefit. Because she decided to go there, we pay the doctor $100. That's the amount that they charge, and then we're going to send a $60 check to her directly. Okay, that's what we call the excess indemnity. So that's the beauty of our product. Again, it's a fixed amount. This is what we're going to pay regardless. We're not going to penalize them for you know where they want to go, but just make sure you educate them. That's what they're going to get, $160. She could have went to her doctor. We're not going to stop her, but she would have been responsible for $140. All right, so right below that, this is something that we've, oh, by the way, for that 20, so for the doctor's visit, we actually give your clients 20 doctor visits. My boss will tell you this, our competitors, they have 5. I think I've seen, the most I've seen from other companies is 7. We actually give you guys 20. On top of that, we even added 6 for chiropractor that can be used out of the 20. And then for this year, we've added 2 for specialists. Okay? And what I mean by that, right below that, specialist physician indemnity benefit, we pay $150 for the middle plan on that. Examples for that, let me see if I can think. Like, gosh, I'm just blanking out. So anyways, for specialists, like if you're getting a mole removed, that's typically surgery benefit done at an office. So for that particular example, again, for the middle plan, we would actually pay the specialist for that, which is $150 for that visit. And then plus right below that is a $200 for the middle plan. So to get a mole removed, we're going to pay $350. That's something that we've added. a new benefit that was not on the Health Choice Select or the Health Saver Plus. Also, we pay for MRI, PET scan, CAT, nuclear testing indemnity benefit. Again, middle plan is $500 for that. X-rays, other diagnostic, $160 per day. Lab indemnity benefit, $80 for the middle plan. Injection, we pay $60 per day, okay? The next two is the emergency department indemnity benefit and the urgent care. This is something different from the previous Health Choice Select. So we've added, so they can use a maximum of one for emergency benefit. We pay $300 on a middle plan for that. Urgent care right below that, if they decide to take advantage of that, and we highly recommend the urgent care. We also pay $300 for that. They can get a maximum of two benefits per calendar year. Just to give you an idea, my boss and I, we met up with, he works for this urgent care. I think it's called Next Care. Anyways, we're going over some numbers. The average cost for urgent care, guys, is about $145, okay? And I don't know if the slide is in here, but we pay $300 for the unit plan, for the middle plan. If they go to urgent care, not only will they get taken care, they can put money on their pocket. $155 possibly they can put on their pocket. So definitely try to encourage them to go to urgent care if they can, okay? Ambulance indemnity benefit, it's $1,000 for ground, $2,500 for air. We also pay for prescription. Again, I'm just going to go over the middle plan. Generic is $20 per day, and then the brand name we pay $40. And right below that is the preventive care benefits. Okay. Please note for preventive care, they can start using this benefit after their 60th day. Okay. So if one of your clients, they try to go get a mammogram, a month after they purchased the policy, unfortunately, we're going to have to deny that. Please let them know that preventive care, they can use it on the 61st day, okay? So preventive care, mammogram, as I said, we pay $250. Colonoscopy, policy year 1 through 3, we pay $500. Fourth year, we pay $750. This is without the polyp, just so you guys know. All other preventive care services, we also pay $250 per calendar year.
Hey, Jeffrey, let's go back to that last slide real quickly.
Okay.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, I am a current Health Choice Select customer. And the middle plan on Health Choice Select, just so you know, for the daily outpatient benefits, I have a calendar year maximum of $4,000 instead of, on this one, $6,000. I have an $80 per day outpatient visit benefit instead of $120 on this one. You get the two extra, well, they're not two extra. I guess the two specialist visits are part of the $20, correct, Jeffrey?
That is correct.
But they pay that at $150. So if I go to the cardiologist, for example, I'm going to get $150 for that visit instead of $120. And the way I understand it is if I do two specialist visits, then I do a third one, I'm still going to get $120.
That is correct. So if you decide to go over two, again, it's not that we're not going to pay any more. It's just that we're only going to pay the $120.
Mm-hmm. Now, I also just in comparison real quickly here, I want to keep this moving. And we appreciate your questions that have been coming in on the chat message. So on my plan, I don't have this additional surgery benefit in a physician's office. That's kind of nice to have that on there. The MRI, PET, or CAT scan or nuclear testing, I think, is only $350 on the one I have now. X-rays are only $80. Labs are $40. Injections are like $20. So you can see these are very enriched and enhanced benefit amounts. Emergency room and urgent care, you have a limited amount of benefits here, and we do encourage folks to use the Teladoc. That can save you a trip, and when you're not feeling well, who wants to go to urgent care or the emergency room anyways? You can do an online consultation with a doctor who can write you a prescription. So if you're feeling like you're getting the flu, you don't want to go sit in the urgent care for 2 or 3 hours anyways where people are coughing and hacking on you. You can sit at home in your comfy pants, and the doctor can send your prescription wherever you want them to. It's a fantastic benefit, and it's unlimited usage 24/7, ladies and gentlemen. So that can save on your 20 visits for the year, too. So prescription benefits have been increased. I believe the ambulances have been increased, and these preventative care benefits. So I'm going to talk about real quickly here, colonoscopy, for example. If there's no polyps, once you're at that $750 benefit amount, that should be pretty close to covering. And so... okay, I'm going to be quiet here. I'm taking over from Jeffrey.
Oh, no problem. Thank you for that. All right, so, okay, moving on. All right, so other riders that you can add on the policy, we have the critical illness rider that you can add. It goes from $10,000 to $50,000. We also have the 24-hour accident policy, which can add, you know, an additional $4,000 for any accidents. Also, dental choice, we have all these you can add in addition to the Health Saver Plus Gold. Okay. All right, so value-added benefits. The three value-added benefits that we have, like I said earlier, we have the Teladoc. It's very neat. Script Save, that's for discount for prescriptions. And the Caris Group 360. I'll go over each one, okay? Teladoc, I have it myself. You know, since I work for the company, they gave it to us for free. I could talk to any doctor anytime, okay, 24/7. Basically, you talk to a doctor. I get allergies every year, unfortunately, I hate to admit it. I talk to my doctor, and he'll have my prescriptions ready at Walgreens in 2 hours, okay? That's how neat it is. You don't have to miss work. It's free of charge. The company does pay for the service, but we give it to all our policyholders. Make sure you go over this. It's very neat. It's very convenient. I even have an agent share a story with me yesterday. He had a client that went travel from one state to another, forgot their prescription, okay? Used Teladoc. They were able to basically help them with their medicine. Was able to get 1 week worth of medicine just for something like that. It was very convenient. Okay, Caris 360, again, one of my favorites. They do a few things. So one of the services they provide for non-emergency procedure, your clients can reach out to them. They'll find them providers in the area. Not only that, again, you guys know what we pay with our plan. Everything's on the brochure. Caris 360, they provide prices for them, okay? So that way there's not going to be any surprises. My favorite part, the healthcare navigator, anytime they have a bill that's $2,500 or more, Caris 360, they will negotiate on their behalf. I'll tell you this. I don't know if it's on this slide. I have I had a client from Florida, had a $43,000 bill. I think it was stomach related. We got it down to $0, from $43,000 to zero. Somebody with a PET scan, I think I forget the exact figure. I believe it was like $3,500. Got it down to like $600. So Carries 360. It's not always guaranteed, but you know that's what they're there for. It's free of charge for the customers. They can use it anytime. And it's very convenient. Okay. Oh, here it is. So here's one of the example. I don't know if you guys can see. This is the original bill was $63,000. After Caris's financial assistance, it was reduced to almost 90% discount. Okay, from $63,000, their bill went down to $6,696, $7,000. So that's a discount of almost $57,000. Caris was able to negotiate 90% dollars off. Remember, I was talking about the MSRP price. This is it. Okay. This is the one I was telling you guys about. I was actually wrong. It was $45,000. This is something personally I worked with. We got it down from $45,000 to zero. Okay. This is what Caris does. Okay. And again, this is included on their policy. So please make sure you go over this. Also, a value-added benefit is the ScriptSave card, save on brand name and generic prescriptions. As you can see, if you want to write down that link down below, ScriptSave.com, www.ScriptSave.com. Let me see. All right, so this is it. This is it. ScriptSave.com. Literally, you can just, you know, go over your client's prescription. You can type it in. And you can see, you know, you want to help them, okay? Again, you know what we pay for. You know, we pay $20 for generic. We pay $40 on brand name. Walmart charges $11.27 for Lipitor, whereas, you know, CVS, $70. If they go to CVS and we pay $20 out of that $70, $50, they'll be responsible. They're not going to be very happy. So you want to help them. Let them know, hey, if you can go to Walmart down the street, it might be more benefit for you, okay? You could actually put money on your pocket.
This will be for the network or provider search.
Yes.
So anybody can go right onto the New Era Life website. You don't even have to be a customer or an agent to look up doctors.
That is correct. Also, not showing on this slide, as I mentioned earlier, we do have the Health Saver Plus Gold with specified disease. Just a side note on that. So if you put those two together, if you sign up somebody with the gold and specified disease, that changes their network from a limited benefit network to the full network, okay? And again, this is a little bit outdated, but if you go to our website, you'll see that option on the top right-hand corner. All right, so this is just a chart that my boss has. Again, I'm in Houston, Texas, just to give you an idea how much discount by taking advantage of our network. The average is about 47% here in Houston. Pennsylvania, 58. York, Pennsylvania, it's about 36. So it varies by area, but just to give you guys an idea, if they take advantage of that PHCS network, again, we're not going to penalize them. They actually get discount, all right? So actual reprice claim. Okay, let me take a look at this real quick. I believe this is one of our policyholder who is a carpenter. And I'm sad to say he cut off his finger, okay? So this is an actual EOB. Main thing I want you to see on this is the charge is basically for general anesthesia. It's $1,785 was the actual charge. Discount of almost $900. I'm sorry, discount of almost 50%. Got that down to $896.75. Okay, just remember that number. So let's just say $900. All right, for that, that's for general anesthesia. All right, so the next slide. This is for the surgeon fee, like we were talking about earlier. Again, the main thing I want you to see is $10,111 is the total charge. Savings of almost 57%, and from 10,111, we got it down to 4,361, again, because this person took advantage of the PHCS network. So 900 plus 4,300, that's about 5,200, if I'm not mistaken. I mentioned that because this person actually purchased a 24-hour accident policy. Okay, so because he cut off his finger by accident, just on that 24-hour accident policy, he got $4,000 for that. I don't know if you guys have access to the brochure. You'll find it on our website. But for cutting off a finger, it's an additional $1,000. So just for having that 24-hour accident policy almost paid for the whole entire thing, okay? And then plus the, I believe this person had a HealthSaver Plus 3, so it pays in addition to that. So I can tell you for this guy that cut off his finger, and no, I'm not recommending cutting off a finger, but he actually got money on his pocket, okay? Because he had the HealthSaver Plus 3 and the 24-hour accident. Okay, so this is the slide that, I've seen this one. So urgent care versus emergency room, just to give you guys an idea, look at that back problem. Urgent care, they charge $160 for that, whereas the freestanding ER, it's about $1,700. Can you guys believe that? $160 versus $1,700. Let's see. Allergy reactions, that's one of my favorites. So, again, for urgent care, it's $159. For ER, for that, it's about $1,100, $1,300. Guys, I can't express this enough. Urgent care, try to convince your clients to go to urgent care if they can. Again, the middle plan alone, we pay $300. So, as you can see, $300 for the middle plan is plenty of money for the charges that they offer at urgent care. Okay, healthcare blue book. I use this every day. Every time I get a call from clients or agent Jeff, I need somebody. I was helping hernia surgery. This is just like if you're buying a car, Kelly Blue Book. So this is healthcarebluebook.com. It gives you an idea how much it costs. As you can see right here, colonoscopy. Okay, fair price is $2,300. It even gives you location right down below Preston Crossing. Which is about 10 miles. You can see it's green, so that means it's fair price. Whereas Baylor Surgical in Richardson, you're looking at about $8,500 and above. Again, if you remember colonoscopy, I believe we paid $3,500. Okay, so even if they charge $2,300, the $3,500 that we're giving for this procedure should be plenty of money. The main thing is, take advantage of this healthcare blue book. It'll help you guide, tell you where to go. Again, don't forget about Caris. And then also in the back of the brochure, there's an 888 number there. Call that number. That goes directly to the home office. We'll guide your clients. We'll tell them where to go. Again, we're not going to stop them from, you know, them going where they want to go, but we want to educate them. We want to tell them where they can go for this price. That way they won't be surprised, okay? So that's what Healthcare Blue Book is. Again, one of my favorite, Surgery Center of Oklahoma, and they have a very neat video on YouTube. Again, they offer transparent. So if you look on this shoulder, yeah, knee replacement, $15,500, it'll give you an actual price. I can tell you that $15,500 is one of the best prices I've seen, okay? Free Market Medical Association, I was fortunate enough to join them this past March. So this is a group of doctors and providers that offer transparency. They're getting bigger as the day goes on. So they have Texas Free Market, again, Surgery Center of Oklahoma. These are providers that actually show their prices. They have them online, okay? One of them, one of the members on that FMMA group is Green Imaging. I use them a lot. Again, just to give you an example, I was helping somebody yesterday with that was needing an x-ray. X-ray, I got them for $125. I believe we pay $240 for x-ray for the middle plan. So again, take advantage of them. They're all over nationwide, as you can see on the next slide. There we go. So as you can see, they have locations everywhere in the United States. All you have to do is go into their website, greenimaging.net, type in the zip code, and then you'll find one nearest you. Okay, Solis, this is my boss. He happened to use Solis. His wife was needing a mammogram. I blew the surprise. So basically, his wife was needing a mammogram, went to Solis. He's in Dallas. Mammogram, if you can remember, we paid $250 for mammogram. His wife was able to get it for $99 by going to Solis. The interesting part about this is right when she actually swiped her card for $99, the lady in the cashier said, you're smart. Because if you would have given us your card, so she paid cash price. So if she would have given us your card, they would have charged her like $250 for the same mammogram. But because she asked for cash price, she was able to get it for $99. So again, if you remember, mammogram, we paid $250. We paid plenty enough for mammogram as far as our benefit. Okay.
Yeah, Jeffrey. Oh, yes. As I recall from the other webinars I've sat in with Dave, the encouragement that you want to give your clients is if they're going for testing or something like that and they're trying to shop around and price it out and whatever, they can say, I'm private pay.
Private pay,
If they get asked, do you have insurance? Tell them to just say, I'm private pay. We're not telling people to lie and say, oh, I don't have insurance, or I have insurance, but it doesn't, has limited benefit. It's not a major medical. You want to just tell them to say, hey, I'm private pay. It's not illegal, or anything to say that. But... these providers have sticker prices. I think we're all aware of this. And a lot of times, some of those bills that you saw earlier that Karis got involved with negotiating them down, those are sticker prices. Like Jeffrey said, nobody pays sticker price for a car anymore these days, nor should we for our health care. In this type of plan, we encourage customers to play a more proactive role in shopping for their services and also negotiating. They can do some negotiating on their own, and when they need extra help, they can get the Karis group involved. So, okay.
Yeah, no, thank you for that. If you don't mind, I want to share this other story. I was actually helping a lady last week. She was needing hernia surgery, okay? Hernia surgery. I believe she was in Tennessee. She sent me an email. Jeff, I need a hernia surgery as soon as possible. I went to this provider. They gave me a quote for hernia surgery for $26,000, okay? I checked it out. It happened to be part of our network, so chances are, for the hernia surgery, we probably would have gotten it down from $26,000, if I were to guess, probably down to $20,000. However, I advise her, hey, why don't you just ask them if they offer private pay? Guess what? So they said yes. So they offered private pay and got it down to $7,000. I'm not kidding you guys. I have this email. So from $26,000. Got it down to $7,000. The reason I mention this is because, I know not everybody can swipe a credit card for $7,000, but if you can just imagine this hernia surgery that she's needing, and also we actually pay, I believe, I don't have the exact figure, but we pay a little bit over $6,000 for the benefit. So long story short, she would have been responsible for almost like 13 grand or 14 grand or whatever the math is, but instead she was only down $1,000 because she asked for private pay. Again, it doesn't matter whether you hand in a card or you swipe your credit card. We are going to pay what we say we're going to pay on our brochure. So because she was a smart shopper, she went from being down to $14,000 balance and got it down to probably like less than $1,000, and she got her hernia surgery. So thank you for sharing that, Dan. But yeah, that's, it's less paperwork for the provider. Everybody, when you offer somebody cash price or private pay, Everybody jumps on that. So typically, that's a lot of discount. You know, so that's just a story I wanted to share. It's a very good story, and she was very happy. Like I said, her bill went down from $14,000 to less than $1,000, and she got her hernia surgery. So, all right. So this is one of our top agents, actually also slash policyholder. I believe he was skiing. This is a shoulder surgery. The main thing you guys need to see on this is the total amount for that shoulder surgery was $10,900. Okay. I'm sorry. Let me back up. So the original bill is $12,395. It was discounted to $7,251. So his balance was $4,144. Okay. His benefit, he's got a 3-unit plan. Again, we pay for the room, we pay for the surgeon, we pay for anesthesia. We paid the provider $4,144, whatever they asked for. So guess who got the rest of the money? Let me see. Oops, I went too far. Sorry. He got the rest of the $6,771. So again, he knew where to go. The particular provider that he went actually for that shoulder surgery is one of those three that I just mentioned earlier, Star Medical Center. So yeah, he got $6,700 on his bank account. All right, so here's another one. I forget what this is, but the main thing, again, I believe it's a knee surgery. I could be wrong, but the total bill was $56,379. Again, he went into network, is part of the network, got that discounted to $44,143. The total bill, this one, he happened to have a Health Saver Plus 3, so the deductible is $2,500. So that's what Dan was saying earlier. Even with the deductible, his total bill was $12,235. What we pay on our amount, I believe he also has a 3-unit plan. We pay $19,250, okay? We pay the provider $12,235. Guess who got the remaining $7,014? The policyholder. So. Okay, so this is just an article that my boss found. Again, he's in Dallas. Teacher's bill cut from $109,000 to $332,000, guys. Again, $109,000 down to $332,000. I believe it was heart attack. Yeah, heart related. He went into the newspaper company and after complaining, after making telling them, hey, I'm going to go to the newspaper and publish this. They got his bill down from $109,000 to $332,000. That tells you exactly, we talked about the sticker price. So you can always negotiate. It's not always the final number. All right. So once again, pre-existing conditions, just to remind you guys, a condition for which treatment was rendered or recommended by the doctor, for which drugs or medicine was prescribed, within 12 months prior to a covered person's effective date will not be covered for the following 12 months period, okay? So we do have pre-existing conditions not covered for the first 12 months. Okay, so unfortunately, I believe this is old. So just to give you guys an idea, currently for bonus incentives, we have the LEAD program. For any production that you guys produce, we give you guys LEAD credits that you guys can use to purchase. We just introduced the Christmas bonus campaign. Again, there if you guys need a flyer for that, I have that as well. But based on your production, you can make from $250, $500, $750, or $1,000. And also, we just announced our 2020 trip. It's going to be in Santa Barbara, California. So that being said, for every application you submit starting now, it counts towards all three incentives, okay? So you get LEAD credits, LEAD Christmas bonus, and then if you're trying to go for the big one, there's also the Santa Barbara trip that's coming up in 2020.
Jeffrey, rather than trying to go over this page here, which has a lot of information,
yes.
These agents have been with us now for over an hour, and I was wondering if we can maybe have it open for some questions. This page here, ladies and gentlemen, it's just going over the differences or the improvements. Oh, go ahead and talk about the specified disease and the other new policy as well.
Okay. Do we have that in here? Oh, there it is. So again,
yep,
so what we came out with August the 15th. Oops, it's moving. So August the 15th, when the Health Saver Plus Gold came out, we figured we put along two other products. So we also came out with a specified disease, and the as you can see in the next slide, it's the catastrophic axis. So we came out with two other products. So first one is a specified disease. It's a $2 million lifetime maximum benefit. Again, they have to choose the calendar year max benefit, $250,000, $500,000, or $1 million. And then the deductibles are $25,000, $50,000, $75,000, or $100,000. Okay? As you can see, it covers all the diseases listed on that brochure, heart attack, stroke, cancer, let's see, amputation, joint replacement. Everything on that list is covered, okay? Just a reminder, it must be sold with a health plan. So if you have somebody with a Health Choice Select, you can put it together with this, okay? Health Choice Select or Health Saver Plus Gold, you can sell them this product. So they just have to have one or the other.
Go back one to the accident, catastrophic accident, right there. Can you see
okay.
that, Jeff?
Jeffrey. Yeah, my screen's not changing, so I'm assuming everyone can see the accident. I think mine froze.
It should be on the accident expense policy now.
Okay, there it is. I'm sorry. All right, so the accident expense policy, again, it must be sold with a HSP series. It can also be sold with the Health Choice Select. All right, so... this one is also $2 million lifetime maximum benefit. Again, the choices for calendar year max benefit are $250,000, $500,000, or $1 million. And then also they would have to choose the deductible, $25,000, $50,000, $75,000, or $100,000. All right, so accident can happen in places as where as you and your family spend most time. So this is definitely we recommend bundling these two products with, again, if you're doing the Health Saver Plus Gold, definitely recommend putting these two. Or if not, if they're within a budget, at least a 24-hour accident and the critical illness, either way, these two products, okay, they're going to plug in the holes that you know, we have on this. So definitely recommend if they have the budget, try to do the specified disease and the accident expense as well, okay? Hey, Dan, so do you want to open the floor for questions for those that have questions?
Yeah, absolutely. We want to, first of all, thank you, Jeffrey. You did an excellent job of going over these new products for us. And I know you guys are very busy right now in this selling season, and I don't want to take up too much more of your time, but I do want to open it up for any further questions that you might have, so you can type those in the chat box, please. I don't want to I want to keep everyone muted because it gets a little bit of chaos if we're all trying to talk over each other. But if you can just type your questions in, I've been answering some as we've gone along, and then let me just go over those real quick. I will, when we're done here, I will send everyone the benefit guide or guides actually for these products that we've been discussing today. You may not have been able to see them that well. So someone asked, Kevin asked, how does using the PHCS network help? I think we answered that question as we went along. It's usually 30 to 50% less in the charges because of pre-negotiated rates. Let's see. Had a question, is there a rate sheet? And I think there is. Jeffrey, can you confirm if there's a rate sheet?
There is a rate sheet, Dan. However, I mean, I can email that to you. However, we recommend all our agents to take advantage of our portal. On that portal, there's a couple ways you can get the rates. There's a tab under online application that's quick quote. I use that all the time. So try to use that if you can. All you need is a zip code, the age of the person, and if they're a smoker or not, and it'll give you the quote right away. And the other one is the EAP, obviously. But I say that because if you do it manually, there's a very good chance that you might get the wrong amount, okay? Because you would have to calculate it, based on the choices that those three choices that they have to make. So right. I advise to use our portal to get the rates, please.
Yeah, the rate sheet would be very expansive to go through. You got different ages, different size families, all kinds of different factors involved. Tobacco, non-tobacco, they do rate up about 5 or 6%, I think, for tobacco use within the last 24 months. So keep that in mind. And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, anytime, if you're not appointed with Philadelphia American, if you would like a quote, I can provide that for you within a matter of moments. But again, we would hope that if you're not appointed, that you would like to be appointed for this product through Insurance Advisors Direct. And I will be following up with everyone personally after this. We had another great question from Brenda. Can you have this plan and also have another plan, say, from your employer? The question was from Brenda. She said, can you have this plan and also have another plan from, say, your employer?
From employer. The answer is yes, absolutely. Again, we're not going to stop you from that. Just know that we're not going to be coordinating as far as our benefits. So what I mean by that is we're going to pay the benefits based on that bill or the CPT code. So we're not going to coordinate with the major medical policy. So So actually, yesterday I was helping somebody with a Blue Cross Blue Shield and was asking if they want to purchase our policy. So yes, they're more than welcome to have both. Again, just know that we don't coordinate. So we pay our benefits based on the claim.
All right. Thank you, Jeffrey. I'm going to let you go. I know you're busy as well. and all of the agents out there, thank you so much. Can I get one last question from you, though? The Health Savers Plus 3 product. I know some of our agents on this webinar here today have some clients on the HSP3 product. What is happening with that? Are people on that plan still going to be able to keep it? And
absolutely.
What advice do you give to us agents who have clients on the Health Choice Select product?
Okay. So both the Health Saver Plus 3 and the Health Choice Select are here to stay for as long as they keep paying their premium. We're not going to remove their coverage, okay? Health Saver Plus 3, we did remove it on our e-app platform. The reason for that is because we have the Health Saver Plus Gold. There's no need to have it. So we recommend that you guys do the Health Saver Plus Gold. As we mentioned, the benefits are a lot richer, especially on the outpatient side. Nothing has been reduced. So, again, that's the reason why we took away the Health Saver Plus 3. If you have any healthy clients that you want to switch over from the Health Saver Plus 3 or the Health Choice Select to the Gold, you're more than welcome to. Just know that they're going to have to go through the underwriting process again, okay? And also their 12-month pre-existing is going to start all over again. That's the only two things that I want to mention. I do have a slide or a PowerPoint for that if you want me to share that with you, Dan, so you can share with everyone.
Yeah, maybe if you could email that to me, Jeffrey, and then I can share it with the rest of the folks on the webinar here today. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you so much. You see my contact information here in the upper right-hand corner. You also see Jeffrey's contact information and Dave Collette, who couldn't be with us today. We really appreciate you taking your time out. Any last closing thoughts, Jeffrey, before you go?
Go sell.
Wonderful. Well, we thank you so much, and I hope to maybe we can have you back again on an upcoming webinar if we do this again, which I plan to do. And thank you, everyone. I don't see any other questions coming in. So we're going to go ahead and wrap it up for today and let you guys get back out there in the field and do your thing and go make some money, okay? And stay tuned. We'll probably be doing this on a semi-regular basis, maybe every couple of weeks, have a different type of webinar on the under 65-year-old market. So we know there's a lot of people out there turning 65, and a lot of those folks are married, and a lot of them, they're not, their spouse may be younger, and they may be losing health insurance. So we have some great products available, and it can help you round out your clients. The more policies you have in a household, the more likely you are to retain that business, and then also make a little bit more money and get more referrals. So, thanks a lot, everybody. Have a wonderful day. Have a wonderful weekend, and we will see you soon. Thanks so much.
All right. Thank you, Dan.